Google Image Search can help you visualize the past by using keywords to find pictures from the time and place your ancestor lived, or pictures about artifacts and landmarks that are part of your story. Today, I'm going to give you a number of different keywords that you can use on Google Image Search to find those pictures. Now, Google Images is a free way for you to scour the internet looking for images. So instead of doing a text-based search, you're doing a photo-based search. To access Google Images, you just type in google.com and then come up to this little text link that says Images. And the advantages of using Google Image Search, you can trace the identity of things and places and sometimes people in those photos. You can also see what a bobsled is in Ontario, Canada in the 1850s, and what a St. Brigand's cross is in Ireland. Let me show you some really cool keywords that you can use to help you search Google Images for the topics that are going to come up when you're writing your family history and when you're trying to research a family history and understand the details that are happening in the documents you're discovering. So let's start off by searching the keywords of buildings. Now, you don't want to just type buildings into Google Image Search. You actually want to type in a specific building that you recognize. Now, you can type in any type of building. You can do a farmhouse, especially if it has a particular name. You can put in businesses such as the Chancery Inn Bar, as well as famous buildings or office buildings where your ancestors may have worked. So let's go ahead and try this Chancery Inn Bar in Dublin, Ireland. Click the search magnifying icon. You will get a visual search results page, unlike the text one. If we had searched all on Google, we have all of this text-based stuff, but since we're over on images, our results are going to be images. You have a number of different images that you can explore here, and then when you find one that looks familiar or that you want to explore further, go ahead and click on it, and then a right menu will pop up. It'll be that actual image, and then there will be some links where you can actually go visit the website where this image was found. And what I also like is related images. Sometimes you'll see duplicate images and you'll see different websites that it's associated with, and some of them have larger images than the others, so that's kind of handy. Another building that you might want to investigate is a church. Now, I can't pronounce this actual church in Sweden, but that's okay because Google can know what I'm looking for. You can type in any language and Google will look for it. And notice I have the church in Sweden. Now, when I put just that location, I get quite a few different images of varying styles. When I did church in Sweden, then I got just returns for churches. So adding extra words along with your building in a specific location can help you filter down when you get results that you weren't expecting. Another keyword you can type in is roads. Now, this is kind of fun because you can see pictures of homes along those roads and also find some maps. You can actually put roads in a specific location, so Wake County, North Carolina, and you can get an interstate in Wake County, and you can also get some maps. Let's say you wanted to look for a specific road in a specific location. So I'm going to type in Bloodworth Street in Raleigh, North Carolina. And now the results that I'm getting are homes along this street. Now, if you wanted to change this to vintage photos, then one of the things you can do up here at the top, use tools, and then click color and try black and white and see if that changes things. Well, instead of getting vintage images, I'm actually getting drawings of the floor plan, so that's kind of interesting. But you might find some historical images, but make sure you look at that title because this one doesn't actually look like it belongs in that location. So not all of your results are going to be perfect. You still have to put in your detective hat. go ahead and play with the tools. So size, maybe you just want to have large images. When you're also typing in roads, I also want you to think of routes or routes, and it all depends on where you're from in the world, which way you say. But think of Route 66. So what I like about this image search is that I can get a variety of different images. So I can find maps, I can find actual scenery, I can see the roads, I can see buildings along that route. I really like this one because it dots it all along. You never know what you're going to find when you key things in. Now, what I want to call your attention to are these bubbles across the top. Let's say you typed in Route 66, but you just want maps. So there is a prompt at the top, which will just filter the image results to maps. Or you want a road trip. So here's more images about planning the actual road trip. So it's a map, but telling you the stops to make along the way. You can also filter to a specific place. So I clicked on Arizona, and now I have images from Arizona along the route of Route 66. Now, landmarks are an important part of our family history because landmarks can be in your ancestors' histories, but don't forget yourself. So let me show you two examples of some landmarks that are in my history. Here's something I do like about Google. It's okay if you type things incorrectly. So I'm gonna search for Albritton Tower. I'm looking for the place where Andy proposed to me. Notice I spelled Albrighton Tower, and I didn't put a specific location. And there are a lot of Albrightons, and they're spelled in a number of different ways. But I recognize this one that's right over here on the right. Now, I can click on that, or I could use this bubble prompt above, which is Texas A&M University. And now I'm getting pictures standing under the little crevice of Albritton Tower. I have the full Albritton Tower. I have a landscape view of Texas A&M University with Albritton Tower there as well. So lots of great imagery when you dive in. So it's okay to misspell things. Google's gonna try to figure it out for you. Now another landmark, being that I'm a Houstonian, not native, but I got there as fast as I could, is the statue of Sam Houston that was north of Houston on I-45 as you're driving up to Dallas. This statue is huge. Now, I've paused here because you can start typing in a building or any of these keywords that I recommend, and then Google is going to give you some prompts. So let's say you knew it was near Huntsville, Texas. Well, you can select that or a variation of that. But let's say you're like, I don't think it was near Huntsville, but I remember it was along I-45. I can click that and then I can get into pictures of this massive statue of the first president of the country of Texas when it was its own republic. Have you ever stopped to think that you should go and search for images about an event? Now I'm gonna type in the Moscow Music Peace Festival that happened in the 1980s, the late 1980s. I remember watching Headbangers Ball and watching the Moscow Music Peace Festival on MTV. It was kind of a defining major event in my teenage years. So notice that I type it in and Google is giving me some of the variety of prompts, Bon Jovi, my favorite band, a jacket, a shirt, the year, some other bands that played, attendance, poster. Let's just stay general and see what comes up. You will see a number of those prompts there at the top. The people participated. You're going to see pictures. That was Bon Jovi. I should have recognized Richie Sambora. There's pictures of the lead singer of Motley Crue at that time. There are program photos. And some of the other things I liked is that I can see pictures. I remember seeing the camera take all of these photos of these different angles of people attending from the various angles of the performers, and you can relive that event. So what are some of the major events in your life or in the life of your ancestors that you can type into Google and see pictures of? Now, stick around because I answer that question that you're thinking about already. Can I use these for my family histories, these images that I find? Now, don't limit yourself to people and things. Also search for genealogically related items such as cemeteries. And while there is find a grave and build in graves, sometimes you want establishment shots of particular cemeteries. So go ahead and type in a cemetery and see what images pop up. And I do like that from St. Patrick's Cemetery in Quebec. And notice that I didn't need to capitalize all of the words. And if I misspell something, then Google's gonna say, did you mean this? Is there supposed to be apostrophe S? Well, sure, we'll take the apostrophe S. But if you take it out, there's actually some historic maps that are taking place that you can find. So sometimes you have to spell it correctly and sometimes you need to spell it incorrectly. But I really do like doing a search like this because on Find a Grave, we're really focused on headstones, but on Google search, we can actually pull up establishment shots. We can see different aspects of the cemetery from different angles. Have any of you actually visited this cemetery? Let me know in the comments. Another great term to put into Google image search would be maps. Now you don't have to write out the full place like you would in a genealogy citation or in a pedigree chart where you're saying where something's from. For me, Karlsruhe could be the place where my ancestor Joseph Geisler was before he immigrated to the United States. Let's type in Karlsruhe and see what comes up for the maps. You can see a variety of different styles of maps to help you understand the location where your ancestors lives, maybe the streets, more modern and past. Notice this one puts Karlsruhe in a different format than the one that's up here. And then if you ever want to dive deeper, then you can click through to the image's actual place where it's hosted on the internet. I also like checking out these related images because look what it's pointing out. Each map has something different and unique to share. Another keyword that I want you to start putting into Google image search is traditions. So some of you are aware of traditions that are around your home, such as St. Brigid's Cross. Now let's search for a St. Brigid Cross. And what I really like when I type this in is that I have a lot of different words where I could filter down. But just in general, here are some St. Brigid's Cross. Now the top is sponsored. That's actually where you can go buy one of these. But if you scroll down lower, you're gonna see a lot of different variations of the cross. Now you may be asking yourself, that's great, I found these images. Can I use any of them in my family history projects? The answer is it really depends. It depends on your country and the laws that they have regarding copyright. It depends on who took the picture, and it also depends on when the picture was taken if you didn't take it. Let's say you want to use this image. Can you use it? Well, it depends. Notice that Google warned you they may be subject to copyright law, so you have to click into the actual image and see what it says. Right now, this image is on TripAdvisor, and it's not clear whether this image is in the public domain or not. It is entirely possible that it's not. Now, you can run a tool setting where you click usage rights and select something for Creative Commons license or commercial and other license. But notice now when we run that filter, we're not finding that in that we wanted. So we'll try the other one. And here is the Chancery Inn, but this is a stock photo and you're gonna have to purchase it if you want to use it in your book. So once again, the question is, can you use it? And it all depends on whether that image is in the public domain or not. You might want to find certain images over on Google Image Search and then go over to alternative platforms that I'll link to in our show notes over on our blog that can be helpful for you to find copyright-free images that you can use. Now, keywords are not only used for Google image search. If you haven't watched our videos about keyword searching in newspapers, check out this playlist right here. And if you're ready for something new, check out this playlist right here. can help you